back to my channel. It's me, Illy. Today we're gonna react to Billie Eilish. Same interview, the third year. The fourth is coming up. I'm waiting for that because I love her. So yeah, let's go react to this. And yeah, I hope you love it. Subscribe, like, and comment. Let me know what you guys wanna see next. And yeah, let's go.
Let's do this shit. Year 3. Y'all been asking for it, so you
know. She's so pretty without makeup, man. I wish I had her skin.
My name is Billie Eilish.
My
name is Billie Eilish. I think it's October 18th, 2017.
It's October 18th, 2019.
I'm 15.
I'm 16. I'm 17.
I have 257,000.
I have 6.3 million. 40.7 million.
Follow?
Wow, that's crazy.
1.13 million.
9.6 million.
152 million.
Google searches of me. Bing? Who the fuck uses Bing?
Right?
It's a picture of me and Charlie XCX.
Isn't it the one about me smiling? That's a lot.
10 million?
That's my face! No, that makes
sense. But I really like that because like all these bitches post all the bodies and ass and shit. Fake ass. Fuck that shit.
Somebody else, but that's just me. That shit's hard. Come on.
I'd say probably Khalid, which is weird because he's like just a homie of mine.
Oh, Hailey Bieber, Justin Bieber, Young Thug, Avril Lavigne, Ariana Grande, Kid Cudi, Ty Dolla $ign. Oh, Tiana Taylor. God, there's so many. But like Drake, come on. Drake is like the nicest dude I've ever spoken to. I mean, I've only like texted him, but he's so nice. Like, he does not need to be nice. You know what I mean? He's at a level in his life where he doesn't need to be nice, but he is, you know?
Being Apple's up next artist.
Jeez.
I did Ellen last week. Jimmy Fallon. So many festivals. I met Takashi Murakami. I went to his studio. Dave Grohl's daughter did a cover of my song. He played guitar for her in a talent show, I think. There's been a lot of shit that's happened in the last year. My skin was so bad. Jesus. Look, I'm glowing now.
You yes. Are. I just comment
my
on
skin got
skin.
Better. I was the season opener for SNL. I just sold out a headlining arena tour. Did Howard Stern, Rolling Stone cover, L cover, V cover, Billboard cover. Released the album, had a number one single. Had a number two single for like 16 weeks straight or some shit, right? Mm-hmm. Biggest selling album of the year. I have Drake's phone number. the people that support me. My fans, which I don't like to call fans, my, you know,
supporters,
my family, you know. I was so annoying then. Finishing this album and doing the most crazy shows I'm capable of doing in the next month. I finished that album. Thank the Lords above, because I was about to jump off a building to finish that fucking album. Oh my God. Exhausting. Thank God I finished that shit.
Can you guys believe that she did her first album with her brother in her room?
Like, me and Phineas have had conversations.
That shows she's fucking talented.
Can you believe we actually finished it?
And she doesn't even need to expose her body to nothing. She's just talented.
I love that album. Probably like a fucking 10, dude. I love it. Fuck it. Oh, wait, it's grades. Sorry, A. I never went to school. I never got grades. Sorry, A plus. That's what I meant. Most important thing right now, though, probably would be maintaining my happiness, which I've been experiencing for like the first time in many years lately, which is really cool. And not that my fans aren't like also the other most important thing in the world, and doing shows is also really important to me, and doing crazy shows especially, but I want to stay happy. That's a big goal for me. I don't know if I'm more confident, I just think I know what I'm doing.
She went through some shit.
I think I'm less confident, actually. True, I was less confident for sure. I was definitely not as confident last year as I was before that. But I am
for sure a billion times more confident than both of those years. I feel like I'm probably the most confident I've ever been in my life.
That's good.
I guess. I don't know how the fuck. I don't know how it happened, but I guess I am. Yeah, I'm definitely successful. I was thinking about that, like, earlier today. Because of this interview, I was like...
People love
that. Back then, I thought it was, like, the biggest it was ever going to be. And I thought...
You deserve it, though.
It was the most I was ever going to be recognized, and it was the most anyone's going to know me, and it was the most money that I would have, the most clothes that I'd have, the most shoes that I'd have, and what's crazy, it wasn't. Success is not how well people know you, it's how you're, like, looked at. I genuinely did not think people would care. I can't even stress it enough. I can't believe people care so much. I mean, it's crazy to me. I might be safe if I go to Trader Joe's. No? Not safe. I tried it. I went to Trader Joe's. Did not work. Nope. Did not work. Tried it. I also tried Costco, which I thought I'd be safe at. And
if
that didn't work.
If I see a celebrity, I'm not going to Costco.
The reason it was affecting me so much last year was because
she's like, all I wanted to do was go out. Like a stock
I don't even... think about going out anymore.
Because they're human just like us. Just leave me alone.
I like this life that I have. I like being famous. It's very weird, but it's very cool. And I feel like I can say that now because I used to hate it. I hated doing press and I hated being recognized and I hated kind of everything that had to do with it. There's a lot in fame that's fucking gross and horrible and just miserable, but
it's the good and the bad.
I'm very grateful for it, and it's really rare, and it's really, I'm very lucky, so I'm so done with complaining about it. I complained about it for so long. Probably that stupid Cheeto head man. November 6th, there's an election soon. I really hope everyone votes. So,
and we are right now.
There's an impeachment going on. Honestly, the news is so bad, I can't even... Oh yeah, Beyonce has some twins. And she still looks fly.
That's true.
Kehlani's pregnant. Greta Thunberg, honestly. She's been...
She likes the gossip.
Kicking people's ass.
Just kicking everybody else.
S get it. That can die, okay? S get it! It's supposed to be like, let's get it, but like, S get it! It's so annoying.
Stop.
Oh, that stupid Snapchat filter that's like, Jenna. I'm kind of over the whole, like, jeweling shit.
What the fuck's that?
Like, that shit is so ugly. Like, smoking looks cooler than jeweling.
Oh.
don't smoke, but you know, like, people think I'm pregnant. A lot of people thought I was pregnant for a second.
Really?
They did think I was pregnant.
Oh, because of the
baby. There was like a story on Snapchat the other day. It was like, wait, did Billie Eilish have a baby? It's like, what? Biggest rumor though now,
like, look at yourself first. You talk to shit. Like, bring people down for what, bitch? Shut the fuck up.
No, I don't have a boyfriend. I could not.
If you don't have nothing to say, don't say it at all. Keep it to yourself.
I don't know. I almost had one for like a while, but it wasn't really exclusive, so I don't know what to call that. I hate things that are exclusive. That's so funny. I don't have a boyfriend! I actually did then. But I don't now. I still am on good terms with everybody.
That's good.
And I still have so much love for, like, the person that I was with then. But I am single. And I'm about to turn 18. For the first time in my life, I don't feel the need to be with anyone.
Mm-hmm.
For the first time in my life.
That's good.
I don't have eyes on anyone. She's so young. I'm not in the mood.
Maybe a while.
I don't have enough stamina for it right now. And I'm totally fine with that. So, who knows?
Oh, we have an
hour. I'm open to it. I think the month of May, probably mid-May, I was in a horrible place mentally. So, when a friend of mine died in June, it's pretty bad. In January, I had a meeting showing me the schedule for the whole year. and I sat there and was totally silent and totally still, and just tears like just streamed down my face. I went to my garage and I just cried. It just was very overwhelming, and I was in a really bad place, so.
Yeah.
I don't want to take it for granted. I don't want to take it for granted. I catch myself.
True.
Even some things I've said today, I catch myself. What am I doing? What am I saying? What? 40,000 people? What? Are you ever conscious that you're doing something that you don't want to be doing?
Mm-hmm.
But you're just doing it? It was like that, because I was taking it for granted. And that makes me really mad, and I don't want to be. And I just was. I don't know, I worked really hard on not doing that, as I said in that, and I've kind of held my ground a little bit. I think I've, like, kind of accomplished not taking it for granted. I've been really grateful for everything and really aware lately, and I just was realizing that I was giving too much of myself to other people's lives and to other people's situations, and I was like, you know what, I need this attention on me right now, so, yeah. Fruitvale Station. The storyline is so heartbreaking, dude. That shit grabs you and pulls you and... I can't afford a real chain. They are real. My chains were gifts. I did not buy anything that I'm wearing. I stopped wearing real jewelry, like real diamonds and stuff.
Why?
Because A, I'ma break that shit. B, I'ma lose that shit. C, I got other shit to buy. You know what I mean?
That was
I like
good.
Red a lot. Mm-hmm. I like black. It's been pretty dark lately, so I just wanted to be dark with it. Black is like the only time I can go through the airport and be fine. That's cool, because the airport is normally like basically being at a meet and greet. But if I'm wearing a black beanie and a black shirt and some black pants and some black shoes, I'm pretty good. I don't like them all. Like, I'm not opposed to anything. Anything. Yeah. I feel that there is pressure on me, but I don't feel the pressure. You know what I mean? I feel it less now that it's bigger in a way. It's like performing in front of 80,000 people is way easier than performing in front of 8 people. I don't know why. I kind of would say the no respect element of the being recognized. I want a hug. I want to talk to somebody and hear how their day went. I don't want a camera shoved in my face. Mm-hmm. It's gotten much worse since then.
Oh,
excitement makes you be kind of stupid sometimes. I did this show last week where I went down into the crowd and I just did this to all the hands, and somebody grabbed my hand and yanked me so hard. And I had two of my security guards with my hand in one hand, and or my arm in one hand and their arm in one hand, literally going like this to try to pull me away. And it took a minute to do it. I'm like bending over, and I was also singing Ocean Eyes at the same time. I was like, when they finally let go, I like fell on top of this fucking thing. And then somebody stole my ring. Somebody grabbed my hand and pulled my ring off. Stole it. Whatever. I expect that. And then I leaned back into this one area of always fit. And then this one girl just went to me. And I, at first, I was like, she probably didn't mean to, because she kind of went like this. They're only trying to be loving. And sometimes it just comes off wrong. That's it.
That's...
Don't post everything you think. Should give it to myself then too. But I do it now. I don't anymore. Yay. That's what I was just saying. Sometimes it's better to just shut the fuck up. I would tell 16-year-old me to remember who her best friends are and remember who the people that care about her the most are. And not throw them away for somebody else or for something else.
I don't like to have friends. I don't like to meet people.
I really hope that I'm not an asshole.
because I'm really afraid that I will be, and I really don't want to be. You better not be an asshole.
I don't like following nobody, nothing your ass. To be cool, nothing.
I don't know what an asshole am I?
I'm good.
God, she's so good. See, I didn't... Oh my God, I was so bubbly. But what's funny is I wasn't actually in real life. I just was new to interviews, and I thought I had to be all like bubbly and cute in interviews. When I watched that, when the other one came out last year, I was like, I like didn't know I could swear. I was saying like freaking, what the heck? What the heck? Laryngitis as heck, tiring as heck. Am I an asshole? I don't think I'm an asshole. Maybe, I don't know. I performed for a bunch of Jared Leto's friends and Jared Leto in his house. I performed for Leonardo DiCaprio in Jared's big, huge living room. Maybe watch my Coachella set.
She loves Just
Crazy. Mel C, Sporty Spice came to my show. Avril Lavigne came to my show. Tom York came to my show. Dave Grohl is coming to my show. Billy Joel Armstrong came to my show. Julia Roberts is coming to my show. Leonardo DiCaprio watched my SNL show. Backstage, I don't even know why he was there. Chris Rock.
They love you, bro.
Well, I didn't know for those last couple that they were in there. Bieber, I was thinking about that the whole time.
She loved
Bieber them. And Haley were both watching me, and I luckily I didn't see them, because if I had seen them, I would have lost my shit. Whoa, Lil Wayne. Oh, to perform with Lil Wayne? That's a great answer. Myself, I'm tired of other people. Doing shows with other people is really stressful.
Really?
Brockhampton. Tierra Whack is sick. My favorite artist is Tekno. There isn't one song that I don't like that he puts out. Every single song that man puts out, I love. Shouldn't that count as your favorite artist? As an artist that puts out music that you only like? You know what I mean? Having the approach that no one's had. Trying to write something no one's written. So stupid. I remember that. Trying to write something no one's ever heard? God, what an idiot. See, that's why I'm still bad at it. Because that's what I was trying to do. Fuck! True. That's so funny. Yeah. She's right. Yeah, I still... I'm bad at it. Honestly, I don't know, because I kind of have no idea what to expect. Like, I thought I knew, like, last year, I thought I knew what people would like for my album, and I thought I knew, like, what would be popular. I was so wrong. Bad Guy is, like, the biggest fucking thing ever now, which is so weird. I did not think anyone would like that one. So, I have no clue. I almost have a feeling that the one that I would say is my favorite, like, one right now, people might not even like it. So, I have no idea. The music industry, man. We're all sad as hell. All these artists, we're sad as shit, dude. Everybody I know that's an artist, we are sad motherfuckers. So annoying. Somebody got that tattooed. That quote. Tattooed. I don't think it's fair to say that we're all sad, because I don't think that's true. I was just 16 and friends with a bunch of other, you know, young people that were kind of going through the same stuff, crazy spotlight on them, and they were fucking sad too. And that's why I think I thought that, but I hadn't experienced it. I think it's a move that I need to do. I think it's really difficult, and I think that's what people don't realize.
Or are we gonna take your shit away?
Yeah, it was terrifying, and it's like it still is, but I enjoy it, and I don't know. I enjoy it. Oh, I just want to do everything. I want to create what I want to create when I want to create it. It's going to change. No matter what. Same shit. Whatever I want. I'm not going to tell myself to do something different next year. I'm going to just do what I want next year.
Okay.
That's what I'm doing this year. That I dress and look really different than my music. Which is true for all the old music I have, or like the stuff I put out like years ago. But you gotta remember, I was 13 when Ocean Eyes came out, and then I was 14 when I wrote like all the rest, and then I was 15 when I wrote Don't Smile at Me with my brother when we put that out. Now I'm 16,
And all year I've just been making music that's gonna come out when I'm 17. And then when I'm 17, I'll probably be like, yeah, this isn't me now, but it was me when I was 16. And then I'll make music when I'm 17. And then when I'm 18, I'll be like, this isn't me now.
A genius.
Oh my God, hell yeah. Damn. Articulate. She stated it perfectly, dude. She put it better than I could have put it. I mean, the thing is that the ones that annoy me are the ones that are pretty true. Like, my voice is really soft. And it's not belty and shit. And that people think that I whisper in all my songs. And, like, I do in a couple songs, but I feel like people just say that about because when they heard one fucking song. Like, listen to Wish You Were Gay. A bitch belting. And, like, my belt is not even close to a fucking Adele belt. Adele is, like, a literal god. But it's just different. Like, you don't have to be shouting to be good at singing. My brother's my best friend. My brother's my best friend. My best friend is Phineas. But he is also my brother. Instagram. Probably Instagram. Instagram been hurting my feelings lately. I really see everything, but that's the problem, is that I see everything, so then I see everything I don't want to see.
Don't. You know, it's just... Don't take it to heart. This
fucking...
Don't take it to heart. You can't take it to heart.
Like,
everybody has an opinion, so...
A fan brought me a
notebook. You can't make it everybody happy. You just cannot.
Huge, like... Letters just be true from to my who fans you are, to me, it. All from different people, and it's like
people
tons of pages.
No matter what you do, say.
People throw a lot of things at me on stage. I've been throwing, you know, bras, avocados. A girl gave me this huge, like, stuffed bloche that she made with this, like, velvet material. And I have been sleeping with it for a week now. It's so embarrassing. I wasn't gonna tell anyone that. It's really cozy though. But the other day I was lying in bed thinking, like, what if she put a camera in this thing?
What?
It's really hard to talk about my life and have it not sound like I'm bragging. I said that today too. My nose is so cute in that. Sorry, I just look at that nose. It's like a little button. Sometimes I'll catch myself in a conversation with someone acting like I'm in an interview. And in interviews, you're trained to talk about yourself and not ask the other person about themselves. And so I'll catch myself in conversations where I'm like, shit, like I'm being interviewed. I'm acting like I'm being interviewed instead of acting like I'm talking to a human being. And I think some artists and celebrities haven't even learned that and still just do that. And people I love do that. That I've met where they're trained to talk like they're in an interview, and that's normal, but it's like we forget that we're not, though. Yeah, the first year I was like, you better know how to drive, right? And didn't I say, oh no, I saw this part recently. It was like, you better know how to drive. Ooh. Because I've been putting off driver's ed because that stuff stinks. I hate that stuff. Oh, that stuff stinks. Why didn't I say that shit sucks? Like, I could have said that. Jeez. Hey, Billy, a year ago, you have your dream car. Can you believe it? No, you can't. But you can, though, because it's your car now. It was a Dodge Challenger, matte black. Actually, literally 2 months from today is my birthday. So 2 months after that day, I got my dream car, and I cried for about 3 hours. You better have a Lamborghini. The mom moment, to please. This is my mom. She is sick as a booty. I don't mind. I can stay here that long.
I love it too.
Next year, I hope you're very, very happy and that your happiness you have this year continues and only grows. You have everything you want in life and you help change the world for the better.
Mom's definitely gonna help change the world though, more than I am.
I hope you guys loved it. That was so touching, and I love to see all, like, and now I'm gonna wait for the fourth one this year, 2020. As soon as it comes out, I'm gonna react to it. I hope you guys loved it. I loved it. I love her music. She is touching. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll see you next time, guys. Thank you.